Hello and welcome, guys. Welcome back to Marwell Manor Farm. This is episode 4. Just purchased the brand new roll belt round baler from New Holland, and I'm super excited to put this thing to use. We worked hard on the last episode getting this pretty large hay field ready for baling, and it's finally time. Super excited. Mainly excited because hay, we have straw, now we're gonna have hay. Straw equals bedding, hay equals food. So we're getting super close to getting ready for some cows, guys. We're gonna get this dairy up and going. We should have plenty of hay off of this field here. As I said in the previous episode, I'm gonna hold off on silage just for a bit. Just for a bit. Cows will be just fine on hay. But in the future, I will definitely spoil them on some silage. I'm not really sure how many I'm gonna purchase yet. Anywhere from 10 to 15, I haven't decided. Just yet, as you can see, new roll belt is working perfectly. I hope to get about 3 to 4 bales per row here. And if you're wondering why I left the grass over to the left, I'm going to be square baling some grass bales. Excuse me. I want to square bale some grass bales just to have for the cows in case I need them. I feel like that would be a decent alternative to having to buy a loading wagon and collecting the grass. That way I'll just go ahead and bale up some grass square bales with my Massey Ferguson square baler. So there's our second round bale of this row. I would be happy with 3 per row. Ideally I'd like to get 4, but I don't think we're going to get 4. Overshot that gap right there. I'm telling you, this little Massey Ferguson right here is perfect for hay work, man. Absolutely perfect. I love it. You'll probably hear me say that in every episode and you'll get tired of it, but I can't help it. So there was our third round bale of this row, and we're just gonna come up a little bit short there of our fourth round bale, but I think we'll be okay. I don't know about you guys. If you guys live in a rural area like I do, I live in southern Indiana. Man, there's nothing like driving down a country road and just seeing a field full of round bales. I don't know. Maybe it's just me, but I love that sight almost more than anything. It's just, I don't know, there's something that I just enjoy about seeing those round bales out in fields like this. Might get our 4 round bales on this row. We're already at 2. Give you guys a little in cab view here. See the hot air balloon up in the distance there. Tried to give you guys a back view of the bale coming out. You can't really see much. You can see the door coming up. You can see the accumulator down there rolling. The realism in this game is top notch. Looks like we are going to come close to getting our 4 bales per row. And we do. It's great. That's a great yield on this hay field, considering I haven't put any lime on it and I haven't put manure, slurry, or any kind of dry fertilizer or liquid fertilizer for that matter. I don't know of anybody that puts liquid fertilizer on their hay fields, but My point being, pretty good dang yield for having a non-fertilized hay field. No lime either. Usually where I'm from, we'll spread some manure on our hay fields, and you can go to the local, it's called the co-op where I'm from, and you can buy a, we just call it a buggy of dry fertilizer. And that's common, that's probably the most common two types of fertilizer that you'll see put on hay fields where I'm from. Feel free to leave a comment, guys. Let me know what kind of fertilizer is used in your area in real life on hay fields. I'm curious to see if there's anything other than manure and dry fertilizer. I'm sure there is. I haven't really been counting this row. I would assume that this would be our third row. As you can see up in the right hand corner, I have a worker hired, and we are finishing up planting on, I forget the field number, of our second field, smaller field of the two. We are finishing up planting on that, so plant soybeans. I'll be excited when that's done. We will have to get that, get the herbicide on there, and I probably, now there is some fertilizer injected with that planter, with that horse pronto, so that'll help, and I don't think that I'm going to do a second round of fertilizer on those soybeans this time. I don't really, can't really afford it, so I'm gonna save my money on that. May come back to bite me, but at least I know I will get that first stage of fertilization with the horse pronto planter, and we'll definitely get the herbicide put on there to eradicate those weeds. That's so cool, that hot air balloon in the background, and I love, and hopefully we'll get one on this episode, maybe not, but every now and then a big fighter jet will just fly by, and it sounds so realistic. I did purchase this round baler straight out. The other baler I have, the Massey Ferguson square baler, I do lease, but I decided to go ahead and purchase this round baler straight away. I believe it was $49,000, could be wrong on that. What I did, guys, I went ahead and I feel like I showed you guys enough round bale content, so I went ahead and just cut to me square baling these grass bales. If you see that view right there, that's an awesome view. Seeing that many round bales in the field, that's awesome. So now we're breaking out the Massey Ferguson square baler. There is one straw bale that is in there, so we gotta get that out. Now obviously I know I'm not gonna yield that many grass bales. I'm pushing for, you know, 3 to 4. Just something that when you're feeding hay on this game, you know, the grass, if you're only feeding grass, obviously the grass is gonna go by pretty fast, but if you got hay in there or even the total mixed ration, that grass bar is gonna go down slow. So I know that I don't need all that much, you know, grass hay, but just in case I needed, I went ahead and left a couple rows of straight grass to square bale. I did forget to windrow these, but I'm still going to be able to hit them here. Would have been better if I would have got them windrowed. It's my fault. Yeah, I definitely should have got this windrow. Sloppy farming. Love seeing those round bales up in the distance there. This is a big square baler, and this little Massey Ferguson pulls it with no issue whatsoever. That's awesome. I've been debating, guys, whether I want to eventually put crops in this field or not. This is obviously a very nice hay field, but I feel like it kind of makes an L. So I could still cut some hay off of one side and crop the other side. I've been contemplating that for next planting season. I don't know. I'm never gonna harvest a ton of acres on this map. I'm just not going to. I'm gonna go more of the dairy and probably the hay route as far as source of income. That being said, there is one more field that I've been eyeing that I want to harvest. And that's not to say it won't change in the future. But as of right now, I don't plan on ever harvesting a ton of acreage on this map, particularly. And I like keeping things close to the main home in the game. I will be doing some contracting work in the future episodes. I want to try the new contracting system out. Tried it a little bit on Ravenport, but I feel like it'll be better on this map here. I have looked at it. Most of the contracting is baling. So that might be something I could do, considering that I have that equipment readily available. Almost finishing up the square baling here. Really need to go check on my worker who's finishing up soybean planting. There's a view for you. I'm just gonna tell you right now, that will probably be my thumbnail for this video. Even though I'm gonna confuse people if that's my thumbnail, because I'm gonna have round bales in the foreground, and in the background I'm gonna have a square baler. So that may confuse some people, but oh well, if they watch the video, they'll understand. So that does finishes up baling. Now we got to collect the bales, store them. It's another thing that Oxygen David did an awesome job on, was making some buildings that are perfectly big enough for hay storage. One thing I have been thinking about is, since the Anderson DLC has come out, I will be purchasing one of their round bale collectors eventually. And one thing that I've been wondering is, where am I going to store them? Because as you will see, I plan on storing them in this building here, off to the left, up against the wall. And the base round bale collector stacks them vertically, which is fine for this building. But when I go to the new bale collector from Anderson, I think they collect them more, or they unload them more traditionally in rows. So Might have to find a different place to store my hay. Maybe not, but we'll see. Here I'm checking in on soybean planting. Looks like he is finishing up. Go ahead. And I have to have somewhere to collect these bales. This only collects 8 bales. And if you're watching this and wondering, where's the Anderson DLC? I did not have the Anderson DLC at the time that this video has been posted. So that's why. I promise you guys I will have Anderson DLC in the near future. I think I made another mistake here by purchasing this bale collector straight out. Probably should have leased it down to $25,000 now. I'll manage, but considering I was going to buy the Anderson bale collector, probably should have just leased this one, but I could always go back and sell it and maybe make a quarter, maybe half of my money back. Looked like he was almost done with planting, so that's exciting. I'm going to go ahead and hook the truck to this bale collector here. Probably not the most realistic thing to do, but oh well. You can't do everything realistic on here, right? Go ahead and get the forks on. Well, I think I lied, guys. I'm not going to hook up the truck. Just went ahead and got my forks on. I will hook up the truck in a minute, I promise. I'm not crazy. I hope that you guys don't mind the commentary over the gameplay instead of live audio. I definitely am looking into changing that. And please, guys, leave comments below. Give me some recommendations on gear, headsets, mics, whatever I need to make live audio. Let me know what you guys recommend. And bale collecting has started. I may use this as a thumbnail if I can get a good view. Not exactly sure how many bales are here. It's gonna be so nice with the Anderson bale collector. Being able to only collect 8 bales is a field this big. It's gonna take a lot of time, but you know what? It's better than stacking them on a trailer one by one with a bale spike. I believe this bale collector right here has been in the game. Been on every farming simulator game that's ever been on console. Could be wrong, but if memory serves me correctly, I believe that I'm right. And it's a good bale collector. Went ahead and cut to the barn, guys. Here's where I'm going to store them. See it? As you guys know, it stores them vertically. Perfect spot for storage there. Close to the cows, so when I buy cows, I'll be able to easily feed the mixer and get those cows fed. They are going to be on a hay and grass diet to start off. No silage just yet. I will get there, but going for my second round of bale collection. I've collected 8 so far. Beautiful sight. Another thing I will be doing in a future episode, I need to line this hay field. Definitely need to do that. Lime is relatively cheap and it's necessary, so. If you want good hay, you gotta spend the money to make sure you grow the best hay you can. That's how most things work in life. Finishing up our second round of bale collection. I'm gonna make 16 bales so far. Went in stacked right there. 16 bales in the barn, out of the weather. Dry. Good hay for those cows. I keep talking about the cows. I haven't got them yet, guys. Promise you I will. Eventually, haven't decided how many I'm going to buy. But I can tell you right now, being an Angus producer in real life, I will be buying the black cows that you can get on here. Obviously, I know they're not Angus. They're milk cows, which is frustrating. But I'll get over it. I really wish that I could own a beef operation on this game. That would take the game to the next level for me. But that's going to be wishful thinking. So I'm going to buy 10 to 15 black cows. Because that's what I own. I own about 24 purebred registered black Angus beef cows. And you guys can see my logo is my bull. He is a century bull. His full name is Century 217. I've had him for about 3 to 4 months. He is in his first breeding season on my farm. He is registered. He is a calving ease bull. I'm rambling about my bull, guys. I'm sure you guys do not care, but I love him. If anybody wants to see more pictures of my herd, leave a comment and I will shoot you my email and send you some pictures. Just finished up planting. Got soybeans in the ground, fertilized. That's exciting. I can't wait for my first soybean harvest. I do have plant growth on slow. Try to make it as realistic as I can on that front. Horse pronto, as I'm having trouble backing. Thank you, Oxygen Davidson, for letting me start with the horse pronto. That is a great starter planter on this game. Get that put up. As you can see, I had the third load. Makes 24 bales. If you hear my dog in the background, I apologize. And we're going back for another load, guys. 24 bales so far in the barn, out of the weather, and stored. Yes, my dog is outside, but I am right by a window, and he probably sees a squirrel or a cow And I know that's annoying, but he doesn't mean to. Give you guys an in cab look here coming up. Pretty cool view there. Few more bales left. One more on this load. Looks like we have 2, 4, 6 bales remaining. That will give us a total of 38 round bales on this field. Pretty good yield, if you ask me. I'm pretty happy with that yield. Definitely. Considering there's no lime, no fertilizer, nothing. So that's awesome. This will be plenty of hay for me to get started with the dairy cows. Here I decide that I wanted to try to sell these. I really didn't need, you know, 38 bales, round bales. So I decided to take these to the, I think it's the South Hill Barn. South Manor barn, right? South View, man, I couldn't get it right. And at the time I made this video, guys, I was brand new to this. I'm still learning this map, so I did have some trouble finding it. I'm starting to get pretty familiar with the stores and stuff like that, sale points. But at the time, this has been the first time that I'd been to the barn. Making my way. And here we are. I'm gonna tell you guys right away that I do regret selling these. Ended up getting about, I don't know, I forget how much per bale. I think I only profited $2,000 for 8 bales. Now, in real life, I'll take that all day, but I probably should have just kept them on the game. And I went ahead and cut to the last 6. I just figured I might as well just store these. It's not worth taking them up there and selling them. So I went and stored these in the barn. Gonna leave me with 32 round bales to start my dairy operation. Very exciting. I know I've been talking about it, guys, and I will get to that in the very next episode. Will be all about the cows, so I'm excited for that. Perfect place to store them from Oxygen David. This amazing barn, as I'm trying to get lined up here. Round bales, 38 in total on that hayfield. Really happy with that. Can't wait to see what the yield is when I'm able to get it limed and fertilized. We'll see the difference. Get those babies stored. and put the trailer up and call it a day. Guys, thank you guys for watching. This is the fourth episode of Marwell Manor Farms series. I hope that I'm subtly improving on my content, guys. Just figured out the thumbnails. Hope you like those. Still figuring out all the editing, everything like that. Hope that I'm getting these videos better for you guys, and I'm still trying to grow this brand new channel, so bear with me, guys. Thanks again for watching. Next episode will be all about the cows. I'm going to be buying 10 to 15 dairy cows. Tune in and watch that, guys. Consider liking, consider subscribing, leave your comments. We'll see you in the next video.